हेलो एवरीवन, मेरे साथ इंदर सलीम जी मौजूद हैं और हमारी आवाज़ में कुछ तकनीकी मसाइल पैदा हो गए थे जिसके वो हमने फिक्स करने की कोशिश की है। तो मेरा ख्याल है किसी हद तक तो फिक्स हो गए होंगे, मगर उनकी बात ज़्यादा आपको बेहतर तरीके से समझ आ रही होगी। मेरी आवाज़ में कहीं अगर कोई मसला पेश आ रहा है तो उसके लिए माजत ख्वाह हैं। तो मेरे साथ मौजूद हैं इंदर सलीम जी। इंदर सलीम जी, वेलकम टू
सलीम जी, वेलकम।
हेलो, थैंक यू, थैंक यू सर, फॉर थैंक्स टू तलत बट हु हैज यू नो गिवन एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर मी टू टॉक टू यू अबाउट द करंट सिचुएशन इन कश्मीर फ्रॉम दिल्ली विदाउट बीइंग देयर। दैट्स व्हाट आई फिक्स द कैमरा इन फ्रंट ऑफ ए वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पेंटिंग बिहाइंड मी। इट इज डन बाय अ प्रिजनर इन रांची। इट इज ए टिपिकल पैनऑप्टिकॉनिक डिजाइन ऑफ ए प्रिजन and which reminds me about how the situation in Kashmir is, because this is how when an entire mass of people is controlled by an architectural device called panopticon, and this painting in behind me has done by a prisoner there, so it reminds me about how people are there controlled in a prison like situation.
Inderji, I'm going to ask you three things and I need those answers. I'm going to ask you the three things together, actually. Number one, you took that case to the 370 article case to Supreme Court. So what would be your line of argument, and what are your line of argument at this moment when you're discussing with your lawyer and other people around you? Number one. Number second, do you have any support from public? I know you're an artist, so you're doing that thing as a humanitarian, as a humanity, or you are a human right activist as well. But do you have any support from different political parties at this moment from India, from Kashmir, who are supporting you? Because you need to communicate your message to public, to other people around you. So number one thing, your legal grounds to challenge 370 abrogation. And second thing, I need to know about your political support. Thank you.
Okay, that's great. Thanks a lot. You see, number one, it is a social media, you know, through which we operate here. You know, we don't have a kind of a structure on the ground. There have been a couple of protests here, and I have done a performance, Manto's performance, Tito Alka Kutta at the Constitution Club of India recently, which Talat has actually uploaded also on the JKTV. But apart from that, there is no real link from Kashmir. You know, we really don't know how to operate, you know, how to even think in artistic terms, let alone the actual political ground there. You know, I'm not a political activist, but artistically, I am saying, even if one wants to do something, there is no connectivity. There is no way to link up and to go there and just walk around the streets and see, and even to do a simple painting there is simple. Do a landscape on the Dal Lake is impossibility right now, right? You know, when the entire mass of people is actually in prison, you know, then it is a very dark moment to talk about any kind of an actual resistance against the Indian occupation there. There is no way to think about that. But what is the artistic perception on ground, whether it is in Kashmir, whether it is in India, whether it is elsewhere? Because artist is basically in exile, even in absence of conflict, even if there is no conflict, but there are enough reasons for artists to create, to think a new life. And that in itself, you know, pushes him to some sort of an exile. So it is kind of a double exile. You know, there is exile and there is one more exile pushed out. So the artist's sensibility has been actually exterminated from Kashmir, and it is operating from elsewhere. So there's an artistic code. Artistic code means when the conflict is happening in Kashmir, but through that conflict, the artistic code is able to connect with other artists around the world. Not only artists, I'm not saying an artist in very strict terms, because artist is this time, anybody can be artist. You know, right now you are an artist, I'm an artist, and the listener is also an artist. So there is no way to create a complete binary of artist and the public. You know, there is a artist is kind of very transitory and a very fluid term which can change, right? So the artistic solidarity is actually pouring in to Kashmir from all over India. You know, I'm not saying about Pakistan or elsewhere. It is coming from France, from America, from UK, from everywhere. So all the saner voices of the world that actually includes artists and poets and intellectuals and are basically in solidarity with Kashmir. So I will definitely go into the term called solidarity. Solidarity doesn't mean that you are on the fence. Solidarity means action. When you are standing in solidarity with certain movement or certain issue, you are basically part of that. So solidarity is not kind of an outside phenomena and something is there is inside phenomena. Solidarity means that you are part of it. That's why the Dalits and the communists and the left liberals and the artists and the intellectuals and the writers and even scientists also, you know, even the economists, Amartya Sen. So it's not about the politician is actually divided because they operate on a artificial divide between them. That is fine for them. But I'm saying the people in general, it's not about the identity also. Let us say the Muslim Ummah is not one on Kashmir, but there are political compulsions for that. But I'm saying the solidarity, overwhelming solidarity coming from the people who think is quite huge. That is actually what I call artistic perception. That is where the artistic code can discover itself again and disseminate the idea of sensibility with regard to Kashmir right now.
Ajay, another thing, you took this case to Supreme Court, and there should be a line of argument. Ek line of argument, or maybe someone may aata hai ki you're going to talk about this. Representation and representatives of people of Jammu and Kashmir did not anything in abrogation because assembly dissolved hui thi. But I want to know another thing from you. What is your line of argument? What kind of things you're going to put in front of Supreme Court to prove your case that ye 370 article ki abrogation jo hai wo galat hai? I need your line of argument, which you discuss with your lawyer. For sure, you have to discuss with your lawyer.
The argument, basically, it is the, my friend Saq Mahmood and another journalist called Satish Jacob. This Saq Mahmood is a very, very young and efficient advocate at Supreme Court. And it was his courtesy and it was his generosity and it was his call, basically, to engage me into this activism because it was the first time ever that I have thought of going to Supreme Court because this is a very, very difficult time and I have never experienced it. And going to Supreme Court is not an easy task. So it is basically the generosity of the of Saq Mahmood, who was charged nothing for this and he is actually doing out of his own heart. So actually a very good, great applause goes to Saq Mahmood in the first place. So I think that whenever the hearing will come in Supreme Court, our argument mainly is about the absence of the representation from Kashmir, that is the J&K Legislative Assembly. How can you scrap the two contracts, the fundamental contract of 1947 afterwards, when it was enacted in the Indian Constitution? How can you scrap it without the consent of the J&K? Because that is the part of the contract. So there is a legal even Ram Jethmalani. He's not a Pakistani, right? He's a very noted lawyer, very, very important lawyer. And he said recently, technically, it is impossible to scrap the act, technically, because the legal system is a technical issue. It's not about sentimental thing, Technically, it is impossible to scrap this in absence of the Legislative Assembly. But they have done it unconsciously. And then there is enough reason for every citizen to question it's legal operational mechanism which has been subverted by the government of India on 5th of August. That is actually a fund, and I think not only me, there are a lot of people who understand its value and its possibility, because Supreme Court has in the past overturned many verdicts of the government, many decisions of the government have been overturned by the Supreme Court. So there is a little ray of hope. But let us wait. Let us wait. And I'm not saying optimistic and the pessimistic binary here, but it is a kind of a step. It is again that solidarity issue. It's again that artistic code, which enables a person to go into the Supreme Court. So the result is not known. We don't know what is going to happen in Kashmir or in Supreme Court or what is going to happen in the international area. But it is this right now moment, right now, this moment. This moment is here and now. You and me are talking, and this itself translates into a very immense solidarity to think Kashmir. That is very important.
Inder Salim, I'm not going to drag you into this legal debate because there are a lot of technicalities which we need to discuss when we are taking like any kind of case to Supreme Court. But I want to take your attention to another area, your social activism, and you need a lot of people to connect with you to communicate your message to a huge or public level or to different political parties or different nations. But on that level, when you're discussing or when you're talking to your point on different levels, you need a support of political party, number one thing. Second thing, you need a political party support when you are talking about the national agenda. Because, you know, in Pakistan and India, we are talking about the two big state-sponsored nationalism. So you're talking about a little bit different thing. बिल्कुल एब्सोल्युटली एक अलग चीज है ह्यूमन राइट और कश्मीरियों को सेल्फ डिटर्मिनेशन या टॉकिंग अबाउट इन फेवर ऑफ कश्मीरीज इन बिटवीन टू स्ट्रॉन्ग स्टोन नेशनलिजम्स सो हाउ यू गोना कम्युनिकेट योर मैसेज एज अ आर्टिस्ट आर यू प्लानिंग सम काइंड ऑफ ड्रामा और स्टेज प्लेज ऑन दैट और आर यू टॉकिंग टू डिफरेंट पोलिटिकल पार्टी डिड यू हैव एनी मीटिंग विद अदर पोलिटिकल पार्टीज एट दिस मोमेंट किसी और कोई ग्राउंड लेवल के ऊपर एज अ एक्टिविस्ट व्हाट यू डिड सो फार
Actually, a very, very, very interesting question. You know, engaging political parties in India is a very difficult proposition. Left is already kind of cornered there. You know, you can see it. You know, it is almost reduced to the left in Pakistan. There's a Pakistan has a left, and I have a left background. You know, I was part of the left, and I was also the progressive movement writers movement in 86. I was part of the delegation from Kashmir, and when there was a golden jubilee, and there were many Pakistani writers and artists in Lucknow that time. That was the first time I have ever come out from Kashmir. But over the years, the left has actually been cornered as an anti-national, as something which is unrealistic. It is against God, and they are actually again as the Indian separate. You know, that actually must be happening in Pakistan also. So my only hope is that the left will take the case. But the left themselves are, see, left as a political party themselves are struggling on the ground in India right now. They are very much cornered there, but their presence is there, Sitaram, or their presence is very much there. But how much that will translate into actual politicking on ground, that is actually very kind. Though I am in touch with their cultural branch, that is Sahmat is there. We are there's a huge rally there, and we was part of that. It's quite a big rally from Mandi House to the Parliament on the first day of this scrapping. So there is quite a significant left support coming out very openly about the Kashmir issue. But Congress is the another party which is actually very disappointing. As you know, the Congress, they have really done terrible things in the past, and that's given enough arm to the BJP and to manipulate the political scenario in India right now. That everybody knows. So I'm really doubtful about the political solidarity coming out in a very big way. I mean, I don't know. But I think the mass support, that is actually, I am banking on that. Banking on the mass support means that the Dalits, the intellectuals, the artists, the writers, the workers, their representatives, it is a huge mass of people which is actually there openly in solidarity with the Kashmir issue. Because everybody can feel that the Kashmiris have been bullied. They have been bullied on 5th of August, On 5th of August is a day when an Indian actually starts thinking about Kashmir. So it is a very big turning point. I'm not saying elsewhere because there's enough solidarity coming from elsewhere. But in India, I'm saying it is a big turning point. And it may not translate into a political party, political activism on ground, because I said the BJP has actually appropriated the entire political spectrum right now. You know, we are really not hopeful whether in 2024, there will be change of government. I doubt it now, because the opposition is reduced to something called Rahul, who is really naive about political maneuvering, though he is very sincere at times. But the opposition is quite divided on that. Even Mayawati has actually supported them. You know, there is a politically, it is a very difficult issue. So engaging political parties on some support is actually a waste of time for me. It is this mass of people who are quite impressed by what is actually happening in terms of solidarity coming to Kashmir. So the moment I step on the street right now, or I go into the gallery opening, people talk to me, people want to know what is it. I tell them, you please go and read this book. And more it is opening up. Even yesterday also, there was an artist called Munis Shah from Kashmir who just managed to come out, and he has a presentation of his works in Delhi just day for yesterday. Mm-hmm. And the person who was having a conversation with him talked openly about that for Indians, it is now easier. The task for the Indians has been now easier than before, because they can quickly now think about Kashmir than before. So that's what I'm saying. The 5th of August is a very turning point in terms of the perception, change of perception in India, actually. That is very, very, very important part of it, you know, because somehow people think, you know, it is because India is going through this economic crisis right now. A lot of factories are, you know, winding up. Workers are actually, unemployment is actually increasing. Economy is actually downsliding. So we really don't know what is going to happen after a couple of years. We really don't know. There is no way to predict the after 4 years or 5 years. It can be a civil war. It can be a terrible thing. But I am just hopeful that the Kashmir does not become too violent. Because if the Kashmiris start picking up guns and the stones again, this time there will be terrible bloodshed. And the Indian army will be going really ruthlessly about after the people. And I'm really afraid that it is right now very tragic happening in Kashmir. We really don't know, because there can be disappearances, there can be any number of tortures and killings going on in Kashmir. We really don't know about that. But I hope that the 5th of August gives a new arm, new wisdom, new ways of looking at the resistance. Because resistance is very, 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 you know, kind of a birthright. You resist, but what are the tools of resistance? In 1990, the only tool of resistance was the gun. In 2010, the only tool of resistance was a stone. On 5th of August, maybe the tool of resistance is something else. Maybe it is music, maybe it is theater, maybe it is writing, maybe it is something different, maybe change of dress code. I am looking for a new language coming from Kashmir. That can be helpful to the understanding of new politics of the world. So we are here now questioning about the models of the development. We're questioning about the what is actually Sufi survil. You know, what is this Sufi dance? Sufi dance is not about connecting with the God only. It's about actually the dislocation of the materialistic idea of life. We are basically going elsewhere. That's why we always talk about the Sufi has been a very political person in the past. Now it's only reduced to the love idea. So maybe the new Sufi from Kashmir, maybe he is without a gun, without a stone, but doing something very, very important thing on the Kashmir. That is what I'm saying, that maybe new will come. I don't know, but I'm hopeful about that. Political parties in Kashmir, in India, mainstream India, are reduced to it is a kind of a single party system now. I mean, and that's very unfortunate to say, but BJP has, kind of really, kind of a bully bleed
the
earlier institutions. CBI is there, election commission is there, judiciary is there, cultural institutions are there. BJP has infiltrated all of the institutions through their RSS representatives, right? So it is a very disappointing scenario in India right now. But I am thinking that the thinking person in India, they cannot disappear. That's not possible. They cannot disappear. I'm just hopeful about that.
Another thing, you took this case to Supreme Court, and we know in Supreme Court is going to be decided on the base of the strongest argument. There will be like your lawyer and might be on other side lawyer going to be representative or presenting in front of court. Second important thing, as you said, that most of political parties are not going to be on your side and they will not be on your side in any way. On third level, you need media support to transfer your message, to communicate your message or like in public. So what do you think will be role of media in future, and what will be role of media at this moment, and how are you going to use different kind of media sources to communicate your message?
Good, because your sound is a little bit coming, little faded sound, so I have to go closer to my ear. I think the role of media, social media is not the entire spectrum of the visibility of what is happening on the ground. That is what I'm always talking about. The visibility factor, the image which is actually burdened with the representation right now will not be the complete story of the situation on ground. No matter how many images are coming from Kashmir, we still will not know the magnitude of the pain there. The image is not representing that way. So the social media is one layer of it, but it's not the complete story of the situation there. People have to go themselves and experience it. And people have to talk to the people directly rather than depending on the image coming out of it or a video clip coming. So the social media is one level of it, right? But I am thinking, that's what I go back to the new stimuli, new encouragement for the people in general to go to Kashmir and just think. There are many friends who are right now going to Kashmir to see situation on ground. But the social media, I don't know what flood of images will come out of Kashmir. I really don't know what is the amount of the new documentation which will come out of Kashmir after the curbs are lifted.
So
that will be quite huge.
Inder, did they give you any hearing date of your petition? Do you know about any of their what they're gonna do about your case, or do you have any court date for that?
Okay, I said your sound is coming very very faded one. There is no right now. There is no date coming out here, and. We are waiting for the hearing at Supreme Court. But I think in Kashmir, we are waiting. Maybe I will also travel. In maybe if there's a little bit of, if there is hopeful that we can go, one can go. I can also, I would like to go there and just meet some people there and see how it is happening there. But we are all, everybody is waiting. Everybody is watching and waiting, because things are not promising in Kashmir. That is promising in the sense that maybe there are too many killings that have happened during all this time, during all these days. So we don't know what will happen after the curbs are lifted. And if there is a violence, it will be an absolute misfortune for the entire people here. Because if there are thousands of killings and thousands of tortures and disappearances, that is true. So we... artistically, I don't know how to address that. Unless and until we don't have social media is there, but how much is it there? I know there is an inadequacy in every level of the operation here. But we are imperfect. We are going through these inadequacies. So we have to learn to live with the imperfection of the human being. Imperfection in the sense that it is helpless also there, but we understand that. What can one do? Because the political parties have been cornered, and there's a one section in the BJP who is really quite celebratory, and as Haryana's chief minister is saying that we can get girls from the Kashmir. So they are going so out and humiliating the Kashmiris on ground there. There is no question about that. So how to counter that? The social media is countering their nationalistic jargon on every level, whether it is wire, whether it is, you know, any media, you know, I can see up and down any channel, you know, kind of NDTV is very openly criticizing what is going on there. But all other channels are quite, you know, they have been, you know, pocketed by BJP. They are kind of Godi media, what we know here. Godi media is that they have been bought by the government. So we are not expecting anything from Republic or Time Is Now or other channels. But at the same time, I think we have a possibility to engage on not only on social media, but also going directly there and then just be there, actually go there and then just see what is happening there. That is quite a possibility, and I'm just quite you know, right now I don't have enough language, enough words to talk about what is going on. You know, which is very, I think for me it's very difficult to put things in words. Well, the pain and pressure and the depression of the people there.
Yeah. You know, there
lot of friends there, and lot of people who never wanted to be either with the conflict, or you know, they wanted to have a simple life. You know, there are too many people who want to have a very simple life in some corner of the world. They didn't want to be part of it even, you know. So those people have been dragged into this conflict. Their doors have been, you know, exposed to the midnight knocks of the army. That is actually a very troubling situation right now here, which is very unfortunate, very sad. I don't know how to express in words, but it is very, very problematic to talk about the entire thing through the language. So there has to be a wait and watch, and also it's a kind of a day-to-day struggle right now. You know, that's what I'm saying, that that when we use the word solidarity, it is action. It is not actually you are on the fence. It is not a mere word of solidarity. Solidarity means that you are doing some action the way somebody is doing action somewhere else. Only depends on that your location on the earth is somewhere else. So solidarity has a very deeper, profound interpretation here. So when we are talking about solidarity, it is not merely a hello, okay, I am with you from a very distance. But solidarity is very important. Is it new phenomena coming out?
Inder, as international community, people who are living in Canada, in England, in UK or European Union, they are listening to you at this moment. So what would be your message for these people, that how we can help you? Like, do you have any like a strategy for us? Do you want us to have some kind of protest for you in favor of this petition or which you're taking to Supreme Court? What should we do as international community to help you?
I think people should read about Kashmir. People should read books about Kashmir. People should know the history. I mean, I will recommend people to understand, to at least listen to the music of Kashmir, because Kashmir is not a barren land. Its music is amazing. Its poetry is amazing. We have Kashmiri language is as old as 600 years, written history, you know, kind of thing. So its past is so beautiful, you know, Sanskrit, Persian, Arabic, Kashmiri, and then the English also. So Kashmir is a very fertile land in terms of architecture, in terms of music, literature, folk tales. So and the books which have come out during all these years. So I will recommend that people should actually start reading about Kashmir. It's not only about what is coming on social media. Somebody is writing an essay about Kashmir, and you are happy with that. So the essay cannot compress the entire spectrum of the entire idea of Kashmir in one go. People have to themselves work out the idea of Kashmir themselves, and then come out they must say about that what went wrong, you know, what has been going on all these years. So they may go through the texts
I won't say essays, but they should go to the, there are enough books now, at least 30-40 books are quite available on the Kashmir idea, from both parties, you know, from here. People should read everything about it and then come out with their own ways of it. They will themselves see what has been going on there in Kashmir, and that is actually very important. That thing must happen in Kashmir. That is actually very important. Otherwise, people are actually believing someone else's interpretation. People should actually work out themselves.
Mm-hmm. So, as an artist, because you are one of the excellent artists I ever know. So, as an artist, what would be your strategy? Are you talking to other your friends, your comrade friends, to organize some kind of theaters and drama to promote and to propagate your message? So, what would be, as an artist, what are you going to do?
I think I'm planning have a kind of a artistic meditation at the Press Club of India. I'm just, you know, Press Club India is very, very politically. I'm just proposing a couple of hours event, artistic meditation on Kashmir crisis at Press Club of India. So that is a kind of a new chapter in at that location, because it is the location which is very important. So I'm just planning that thing right now, because that place is quite charged with the political activism there. There are every kind of people are there. So we are not directly talking about what is going on, but we are talking about crisis there. We are talking about the amount of tragedy which is unfolding there in Kashmir, and what are the expressions. So if you see the lectures, the people who are talking on the mic, they're mostly recycling the same thing. You know, if you listen to one voice, I'm saying from the solidarity camp. Even from the solidarity camp, if you listen to one person, if there are 20 person on the panel, they're saying the same thing. Yes, it is wrong. 370 scrapping is wrong. So the recycling of the same content through a political mouth is very much predictable. I'm saying the unpredictable about Kashmir is how to go elsewhere, how to learn to go into the artistic meditation of crisis in Kashmir. I'm using the word, how to go into the artistic meditation of crisis in Kashmir. This is very important way I'm just talking about. Because otherwise, people know now. People know, okay, now it has wrong has happened, but what to do? The what to do is basically people must either, let us say somebody gets up and reads some Akhtar Mahideen story. Akhtar Mahideen is a very, very important, great short story writer from Kashmir. Very, very beautiful. He has written about, actually he has predicted about the things which are coming out now. So reading an Akhtar Mahideen story is quite a resistance right now. You know, so there are so many ways of understanding what is artistic meditation. Artistic meditation is not actually merely a decorative or it's not creating a beautiful frame to the conflict. No, it is basically multiplication of the idea of resistance. So the meditation is not used. That's what I'm going with the Sufi and the political in that sense. The meditation means here how to multiply the idea of resistance. That is not merely possible with the political jargon. I know I am not criticizing that people should not talk about directly what is going on. I'm saying, but I think there are other ways of understanding politics. Other ways are basically not conducive for the usual masses, because masses want to say, okay, how many people are killed? Okay, who killed? And they switch off the television. That is the direct way of understanding politics. We are basically trying to have a sustained, you know, it's like a very slow exercise. Not a fast exercise. That's why I introduced a term in Kashmir. It was published by the Greater Kashmir or other magazines in Kashmir. It was called a slow martyr. The slow martyr is someone who is not a direct martyr. Slow martyr is basically who is not dead or who is not living. You know, huh? That's what is the slow martyrdom here?
what is the slowness of the resistance? If we talk about the slowness of the resistance, slowness of the wind that is passing, it's not about storms. That is how we can actually understand who we are, rather than that's why we can be with the masses, because then we have a huge solidarity coming. People finally don't want violence. They don't want to go to the streets and throw stones and get injured and just see their daughters unsafe on the streets in the night. They don't want to see. Even in Kashmir also, people want to have a trust. The trust comes only when you slow down the idea of who we are. Slow down doesn't mean the passivity here. It means the sustained breath. It means that you are also living tomorrow. You are not actually dying today. You somehow restore your idea of life. You don't burn yourself too quickly. You know, people have been going through terrible times in Kashmir. You know, one thing was called Beghair. Beghair was when the king will take the Kashmiris to the Gilgit and Baltistan area to do free labor. That was called Beghair. And very few people will return back from the Kashmir. From that forced labor, right? But those who return, they return because they sustain themselves, and they live to tell the tale, you know. And they are the people, because everybody was going. There was a from every village, some 10 people who had to go to Beghair every year to the frontier to do the repair work for Maharaja, right? So the people have sustained that those times also. Very difficult times were in the past. People were very poor in this. You also may be knowing about poor people who have been suffering all the time. What is the idea of life that stopped them from committing suicide? Otherwise, the sufferings which have been put on the heads of people by the earlier regimes also were too much. But people have endured that time. That's what I'm saying, that one has to actually think of resistance as a sustainability model. That resistance and the sustainability model must come together. And maybe the new ways of living will come out of Kashmir. You know, what is a simple living, rather than rushing after the commodities as capitalistic societies are actually forcing on us. So maybe there's a new way of thinking there. I'm just hopeful here. So it is this which gives me hope. Not that, of course, the social media is one layer of it. Of course, there is so many political direct articulations are there. But my strength is people. My strength is the average person, is the average thinking person with whom you can talk there. And that is where the multiplication happens. Political parties don't multiply these days. They are there only depending, even on the left also. They have committed terrible mistakes in the past. You know, they have unnecessarily criticized Salman Rushdie in the past, you know, when there was no need. And that they have given excuse to the right wing to say, hello, you are doing appeasing policy. So left has done many mistakes in the past. Congress has done terrible things in the past. And BJP is a open evil, you know. BJP is openly doing the evil thing here. So I'm not banking on the political party, although I am part of the left in that sense, but one thing is there.
Inder, one thing you're dealing with Bharat Mata ki Jai Ho, and then you're on other side, Pakistan Zindabad Ale Nare. In between these two big slogans, do you have any hope to connect people from Indian side, like leftist people from Indian side and leftist people from Pakistan side, to make one movement for people of Kashmir and their self-determination right or their basic fundamental human right? Do you see any hope between a connection between people from Pakistan and India, people who are connected with different kind of leftist political parties? Do you see any hope between them?
I think there are two ways of looking at the situation: the explicit situation and the implicit situation. Right? Explicitly, things unfolding and hello, are you listening to me?
Yeah. I can hear you. Yes. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. So the
explicit situation is that you meet people. You know, you think of some events. You think of creating a new. I gave one slogan in the past. It's called Sazra Pazra Ta Azadi. It was simplicity, truth, and the freedom. So I gave this slogan many years back, but nobody picked it up. Because to talk of simplicity, to talk of truth, is seen as something passive, you know, by the resistance camp. But maybe this slogan is picked up now. If Sazra Pazra Ta Azadi is picked up by the mainstream political parties in Kashmir, it will be a new change. That's what I'm saying. Maybe it's quite possible that the new politics comes out from Kashmir. Maybe the youth will start thinking about new slogans, not the earlier slogans, Pakistan Zindabad and Hindustan Murdabad and all those things, which actually don't produce anything. You know, there has to be some productive way of understanding that how we are sort of sustain. You know, that's what I'm saying, that Kashmiris should be conscious about that the entire world is watching them. The world is looking to Kashmir for a new politics to come out of it. Not as a regressive politics. Regressive politics is basically, if you pick up the gun again, then you are becoming kind of a distant limb of the Pakistani ISI agencies. You know, in Kashmir, they are saying that they are afraid of ISI agents more than the raw agents, because you never know what ISI is doing there. You know, you never know what they're doing in Afghanistan. You never know what's happening in Pakistan. So people on ground actually are very, very suspicious about the armed resistance. The armed resistance has to actually be seen the way it has come. It has come as a state apparatus. It has come out of the statecraft of the Pakistani establishment. And it suited very much the Indian establishment. Indian establishment is actually happy if there is a gun violence, because then they have the excuse to suppress the movement. So I am hopeful that maybe the new youth, the youth from Kashmir coming out of, not, it's not about art. It is about the sustainability model. How to sustain and think resistance. How to sustain, you know, it is not an easy task. It is not actually popular even. Maybe people will not talk too much about it. No, talking about Kashmiri language in Kashmir is, can be resistance right now. If you start implementing Kashmiri language in Kashmir right now vigorously, it is resistance. It is, if people start talking to each other in Kashmiri, is resistance. It is not about the literature. It is resistance. So the resistance, ideas of resistance are actually not coming from the earlier models of the resistance. You know, they're shortcuts, basically. They're shortcuts resistance. The long-term major to resistance is only if you think about how you sustain yourself on ground by doing resistance, by looking at your own life. Otherwise, it is the earlier model is that, okay, if you are with me, or you are not with me, then you can shoot down the... That's why there have been a lot of killings by militants on both sides. You know, Pandits have been killed innocently. Muslims have been killed by militants for no reason. You know, you are an NC political member, so we come in the night and shoot you down. That was actually not the way to start the resistance. Unfortunately, people say it was okay, but I think all the killings in 1990 were unnecessary. You could have done resistance without killings also. So I don't see the killings in Kashmir have been productive at all. It suited only the Pakistan. It suited only the Kashmir. I think the new youth in Kashmir should think about a resistance where the bullet is not important. It is the ink of the scholar which is important. Actually, that is a reference to the prophet also, that the ink of scholar is more important than the bullet of a martyr. But the problem is that people should actually do it on their own. You know, I am actually one of the believers of the simplicity of the prophet. The simplicity of the prophet is actually inspirational, rather than the bloody fields of no. It's actually, it doesn't suit me at all. I am with the ink of the scholar, not with the bullet with the martyr. The ink of the scholar will create more solidarities across the world. That is actually my idea.
Inder Salim, What is your message for those people who want to join you and your movement or want to become part of this petition? Do you have any message or any way they can contact you to become part of this petition?
Well, I mean, I see the petition is actually on the Facebook. And people have been circulating it on their own pages. It is very much a public information now that I have submitted a petition at the Supreme Court. So people give me messages, and when the hearing will come, we will be there, and with Saif Mahmood also, and we will see if what will come out of it. And I maybe there is quite a substantial support from the. From the lawyer community, from the intellectuals, from left and right, so I am hopeful there. Let us see. I mean, I will only come to know when it actually happens. But right now, let us see. We are waiting and watching.
Thank you very much, Inder Salim ji, and JKTV will be there for you whenever you need it. And
thank you very much.
Your camera.
Unfortunately, the sound things have been really disruptive. I was struggling to listen to you, and but that is actually the time in a metaphoric sense. We have to struggle to listen to each other even if there is a technical glitch. So yeah. This is the time. This is basically, I was actually guessing all the time that what you are saying. Maybe I have missed some exact lines from you, but it has been quite a pleasure to talk to you, and also vent out my feelings with limited expression, which I have, because I am not a man of words, and neither I am a political person, because political people are quite trained to use the words. I am not one of them, but I have tried my best to talk to you and just convey my ideas about Kashmir crisis. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Inder Salim ji, and you're amazing. And we're going to invite you again once your petition is for hearing. So we're going to hear from you again.
Of course, Thank of course. You're most welcome. You're most welcome. You're most welcome.
Thank you, ji. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
नाज़रीन, इंदर सलीम जी की जो गुफ्तगु है उसका अगर मैं निचोड़ निकाल के आपके सामने रखूं तो इंदर सलीम जी इज नॉट अ वेरी टेक्निकल पॉलिटिकल गाय. एक आर्टिस्ट है, और आर्टिस्ट जो होता है वो अपने दिल की आवाज़ को जज्बात के ज़रिए, एहसासात के ज़रिए अपने चेहरे पर नमूदार करता है. और उनके गुफ्तगु से आपने अखज तो किया होगा कि एक दिल का दर्द है जो कि उनकी ज़बान पर आ रहा है, और उनके चेहरे के तासुर से भी आपको नुमाया नज़र आता है. इंदर सलीम जी एक कश्मीरी पंडित भी हैं और साथ में एक आर्टिस्ट भी हैं, और उन्होंने 370 आर्टिकल की एब्रोगेशन की पिटीशन सुप्रीम कोर्ट में लेकर जा रहे हैं, जिसके लिए उन्होंने एक लॉयर भी अपने साथ रखे हैं. और उसकी अभी हियरिंग की डेट का इनको नहीं पता, जब पता चलेगा तो हम इनसे दोबारा गुफ्तगू करेंगे. जो लीगल टेक्निकलिटीज है, ज़ाहिर है अदालत इस बात को देखेगी कि कौन सा स्ट्रांग आर्ग्यूमेंट है जिसकी बुनियाद पे इसको डिसाइड किया जाए. पॉलिटिकली उन्होंने आपको बताया कि बहुत सी पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज, ज़ाहिर है वो एक स्पेक्ट्रम ऐसा बन गया है जिसमें वन पार्टी सिस्टम नजर आ रहा है, मगर लेफ्टिस्ट पार्टीज के साथ उन्होंने बड़ी उम्मीद वाबस्ता की है. लेफ्टिस्ट पाकिस्तान के अंदर भी जो पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज हैं उनको भी चाहिए कि अपने मैसेज को वहां तक ट्रांसफर करें. इंदर सलीम के मैसेज को ट्रांसफर होना या कम्युनिकेट होना एक मैस लेवल के ऊपर बहुत जरूरी है, और उसके लिए मीडिया, सोशल मीडिया या किसी भी तरीके से आप उनको सर्च करेंगे, INDER SALIM सलीम, ये उनका सोशल मीडिया फेसबुक का पेज है, ट्विटर पे भी आप उनको फॉलो कीजिए, और पिटीशन वहां पर लगी हुई है जिसको आप शेयर कर सकते हैं, जो पिटीशन ने सुप्रीम कोर्ट में लेकर गए हैं. इंदर सलीम हमारे लिए एक एग्जाम्पल नहीं, एक होप भी है कि इंडिया के अंदर मौजूद ऐसे बहुत से रोशन ख्याल लोग, ऐसे बहुत से तरक्की पसंद लोग, और ऐसे बहुत से जिंदा जहन लोग हैं जो कश्मीरियों के हुकूक के लिए आज भी खड़े हैं, और ऐसे लोगों को आपका साथ चाहिए. क्योंकि इंडिया और पाकिस्तान के अंदर मौजूद जितनी भी कुव्वतें होती हैं वो आम तौर पर अपने आप को इस बात से वाबस्ता कर देते हैं कि ये यहाँ पर एक प्रो पाकिस्तानी ग्रोह होता है और दूसरी तरफ एक प्रो इंडिया का ग्रोह होता है, जो एक दूसरे के मुखालिफ होते हैं. इंडिया और पाकिस्तान का कश्मीर मसला नहीं है, वो कश्मीरियों के बुनियादी इंसानी हकूक का मसला है, और सेल्फ डिटर्मिनेशन उनमें से एक बुनियादी इंसानी हक है जो उनको मिलना चाहिए. हमें शायद पाकिस्तान की सरहदों से और इंडिया की सरहदों से बाहर निकलकर कश्मीरियों के बारे में सोचना होगा, क्योंकि 70 साल हो गए एक कौम मशक़े सितम बनी हुई है, और वहां पर जुल्म और सितम 70 सालों से एक ही तरह से रवा है, और उसको जब तक एड्रेस नहीं करेंगे, ये हमारी ह्यूमैनिटी के लिए बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है। अगर हम हिंदू हैं, मुसलमान हैं, सिख हैं, ईसाई हैं, जिस भी मजहब से ताल्लुक रखते हैं, और जब भी इसके ऊपर बात की जाती है, इस बात को खास ख्याल रखें कि पाकिस्तान में अंदर रहने वाले 35 लाख हिंदू जो हैं, वो भी जब भी किसी मुश्किल का शिकार होते हैं, उनके ऊपर भी जो जुल्म व सितम अगर कहीं होता है तो उनके लिए भी आवाज वैसे ही बुलंद की जानी चाहिए। सरहदों पर तामीर किया हुआ नेशनलिज्म हम इंसानों के खात्मे का सबब बन रहा है। रियासत इंसान के मसाइल में से एक मसला बन गई है, मसाइल का हल नहीं निकाल रही। तो लिहाजा जिन रियासतों की बुनियाद पर नेशनलिज्म कायम किया गया है, कश्मीरियों की जिंदगियों को उसी के अंदर लपेट कर ना देखा जाए। कश्मीरियों को इन रियासती मसाइल से बाहर निकाल के एक इंसानी हकूक का मसले के तौर पर देखा जाए। इंदर सलीम की गुफ्तगू आप सब तक पहुंची, इसे बार बार सुनिए, और उनकी मदद के लिए, उनको आपकी मदद जाहिर है इसलिए तो नहीं चाहिए, कोई माली मदद नहीं चाहिए, उनको आपकी जबान की मदद चाहिए, आपकी मैसेजिंग की मदद चाहिए, उनके मैसेज को मैसिव लेवल के ऊपर जो ट्रांसफर करना है उसमें उनको आपकी मदद चाहिए। आप सबकी समाज का बहुत शुक्रिया।